Hello, fellow Artemis enthusiasts, and welcome to this video explaining how to use pre-built DMX parts to run with Artemis. Now, on the forums quite a while ago, I posted that I had finally unraveled how to actually make them work together. Now, to some of you, it's no secret, but it is pretty difficult to make it work, and there are quite a few pieces and steps that you need to go through to actually make it work. So we're going to split this video up into two distinct portions. The first being the hardware, and the second being the software. Hello, and welcome to part one of my Artemis tutorial. We are going to first outline all of the hardware that you're going to need to complete your Artemis DMX build. Now, first I'm going to start off with the cable itself. This is called DMX cable. You might also hear it referred to as XLR cable, but this is not completely correct. XLR cable is meant for microphones and things of that nature, audio devices, really. And the major difference is it has a different impedance or resistance or whatever you want to call it. Being an electrical engineering major myself, impedance has more meaning to me, but resistance probably has more meaning to you. Now, it isn't crucial that you buy this, but it is suggested. It will make things run better, it will cause less problems in the long run, and really, it doesn't cost a whole heck of a lot more than getting, XLR cable. You want to look for DMX cable. Now, DMX cable has two ends. We're going to put it right up to the camera here. It has a male and female end, and it has three pins. Most low-end DMX devices have three pins. Now, there is higher-end DMX devices which have five pins. Now, what we're going to be dealing with here is only going to use three pins because, we're going for as cheap as possible. So this is the first thing you want to pick up, some nice heavy duty DMX cable. Now I would suggest picking up quite a few lengths of this depending on how many lights you are going to buy, because DMX works on a system of daisy chaining where you have one device. Let's say my microphone here is the first device. You're going to hook that device up. And then you're going to put that to your input, let's say my laptop over here. And then off of this device, you're going to get another DMX cable, and you'll go from the output of that to whatever your next light is. Now, I will set this up a bit later, but that is the gist of daisy chaining. Now we're going to explain one of the most crucial components that you're going to need for your DMX setup to work. Artemis has pre-built files in it to work with DMX. You just need to get the correct adapter to convert from your digital signal to an analog signal which the lights can comprehend. To do this, you're going to want to get one of many adapters. This one right here is a Holiday Coro DMX controller, number 26 and number 30, TinyPix Pixel controller, number 611. The item number for this is number 54/2. Now, I will be posting a link to this in the description of this video. But basically, how this works is it's a wire which has a USB to a Cat 5 connector, or an Ethernet connector. Now there are other DMX cables which go directly from USB to an Ethernet. I mean, I'm sorry, to a DMX port. But I decided to go with this one simply for the cost, and that I already had purchased the adapters to go from Cat 5 to DMX, which I will show you now. these adapters are readily available on Amazon, and here they are. You can see they are Ethernet. You plug the Ethernet in, and you can go to either a female DMX or a male DMX. Now, I find this to be more useful because if you want to plug in different combinations of lights, you aren't just stuck with, you know, a single adapter on the end. You can purchase these adapters for a relatively small fee, and it turns your converter into a more adaptable component. Now, the thing that makes this really special is inside of this USB, there is a special chip which converts from your digital signal from your computer to an analog signal. You'll notice, unfortunately I can't show a close-up here, but in the Ethernet connector, there's only two wires going into this, which serve to control the lights. Next, we're going to take a look at the lights themselves. First, let's take a look at our cans. Now, these are probably one of the simplest and cheapest lights that you can use in your Artemis setup. All they have is 86 LEDs, and on the back, they have a DMX in and out, and plus they have these dip switches. Now, an explanation of how this works. First, you're going to plug into the DMX in. This is where your data flow comes from. You find the correct adapter, you plug it in, and then you would plug in your Ethernet connector, and then to your computer. Now, an explanation of how the dip switches work. Okay, so now people might not understand how these dip switches work. It's rather simple. The dip switches here are numbered from 1 to 10. With 10 off, you have the preset actions that the light will do. It will not be in DMX mode. With 10 on, it puts it in DMX slave mode. And then you use the switches 1 through 9 to code which channel you would like the light to be on. Now, I have it set up very simply. I only have one down because I have my light on channel 1. Now, it uses binary to show you what you actually want to do, and it has it labeled on here. The first switch is 1. The first switch, if I can get it to focus, is 1. The next is 2, 4, 8, 16, and so on. Now, if I wanted it to be on channel 5, I would put down dip switches 1 and 3, because 1 plus 4 equals 5. Now, if I wanted to be on channel 17, I would do dip switch 5, which is 16, plus dip switch 1, which would be 17, 16 plus 1. Now, you can do all of these all the way up to 255 channels, and that's what makes this so special. Now, you're not going to want just one light. You're going to want multiple lights in your Artemis setup, as I did. And first, you're going to have to plug in your adapter so you can control your setup. And then you're going to daisy chain your lights. And the way you do this is you plug your output of this light into the back. Sorry, this is a rather long cable. And then you grab your next light, which I have here in this convenient box. And then you would plug the output of this light into the input of this light. And it's quite as simple as that. There's no magic here, but the thing is, you're going to want to set this light to 1 also, because that will put them on the same channel and they will do the exact same thing. Now, if you want to get a little more complex, you can put this to channel 2 or above, and you will actually, you're going to want to put it to channel 5 because these are 4 channel lights. But you put it to that or above, and you can have this light do a completely different thing from this light because it will be on a different channel set. Now, I will illustrate this in a moment, but I'm going to need to get reset up here. So we're going to jump cut. Last but not least, we have our disco ball. Now, I use this in Artemis as the red alert light, but it also serves other purposes, such as if things hit the ship or the other DMX cues, which we'll learn about later. Now, I really like this light because it throws off some different unique kind of things, and it really spices it up as opposed to just having a light projection up on the wall, which is static, like with this can. Now, this DMX light is controlled slightly differently from the dip switches, which you would find on other lights. This has a digital display on the front, a segment display, which shows you which channel it's on. Now I'm going to go ahead and plug this in and turn it on. And you can see I already have it set to channel 5, which is what I usually use it for. Now the menu button on here will change it back to, you know, its regular presets, and those just go through A1 through A7. But then it also goes to sound, where as it senses sound, it will change sound 1 and sound 2. But then we get back to DMX slave mode. Now, finally, I'm going to do a small tutorial on how these lights are set up and just illustrate how you use the different channels. Okay, so you may be wondering, what is this giant board that he has right in front of him? Now, this isn't particularly necessary to having an Artemis setup. In the actual Artemis setup, this will have nothing to do with it. Now, although that is true, I highly recommend getting a DMX board. For the simple fact that you can control and test your lights with this board, which is very hard to do on your computer or from your computer controlling your lights. It's much easier to see, you know, this slider go up and down as compared to on your computer, you're changing values and you're going back and forth. So I highly recommend getting this DMX board or something akin to it. And, you know, for $50, it really is a good purchase. Now, you can go to my other video reviewing this board to see exactly how it works, but I'm going to be using it to illustrate how the lights work and give you a brief overview of how the daisy chaining works and all of that kind of stuff. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get this set up. Okay, and we're back. Now, I'm going to give you a brief explanation of how these lights work. They work on a system of 255 channels. Now, each channel controls one function of the light. And right now, we're going to be using 16 channels. And as you can see on my board right here, I have 16 sliders. And each one is going to control a specific function of the light. And it's easiest illustrated by using these sliders. Now, for channel 1, I have all of these on different channels. This is channels 1 through 4. Then this one is 5 through 11. And then this one is 12 through 16. These are both 4-channel lights. And this is a 7-channel light. Now, First, I'm going to say the first channel of the first light controls the brightness and flashing. So I'm going to slide it up. See, it doesn't do anything. Now, let me turn on the second channel, which is the brightness of red. Now I'm going to turn on the first channel and see how the first channel controls brightness and the second channel also controls brightness. But the first channel also controls how fast it flashes. So we're going to set it to a medium brightness on the first channel for the rest of this video. And you know, the second channel is red, second is green, and the third is blue. Now, that is the four channels of the first light. Now, we're going to move on to the disco ball. The disco ball has seven channels. So, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The first channel controls overall brightness. So, it won't do anything right now, but as soon as I touch the second channel, it controls the red. Then the third channel, green, and then blue, as you would expect. And again, the first channel controls overall brightness. And then, once you get to channel 9, that controls the strobe. And then channel 10 controls position and movement. Then channel 11, finally, that one controls the different presets, which you can also control on the light. Now, this is where it gets really interesting. Once you get past channel 11, you go to channel 12, which controls this light. Again, it is a four-channel light. So you set the first channel, and then you can use the next ones to control this light. This illustrates that you can have a whole chain of these lights, as I have set up, because I have an input, an output, which then goes to the input of this light, and then this light outputs to this light. So you can have a whole string of these, and they can all be controlled separately. But now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to show you two of these on the same channel, which will act in unison. Now let me just reset this light real quick, and I'm going to put it to channel 1. Now instead of before, where this was controlled by 12, 13, 14, and 15, it will also be controlled as the same as this light with channels 1 through 4. So, see, look. You know, they both move in unison. And you'll see that the disco ball can be controlled separately. See? I'm controlling them separately. Now, this is how I use it in Artemis, because I want these to be used in the same way, at the same time, by the game. So I set these, and these control channels 1 through 4. And I hope that is a brief but thorough explanation of all of the equipment, which you will need to set up a primary Artemis DMX system. Now, I'm going to explain some of the nuances of these lights. Now, in the documentation, which I have right here, these cans say that they, first, from channels 1 to 127 on the first channel, they flash from 1 to 127, then 128 to 255 is the light brightness. Now, this is opposite. It is a manufacturing error in both lights, or an error in the manual. See, what I can do is, I'll put the brightness for both of these on channel 2 up to 255. But then, first is brightness, and then second is flashing. Now, I will go on to continue For the disco ball, starting with channel 5, the first one should be the strobe, and only the strobe. But in reality, it controls the overall brightness. And this is nowhere mentioned in here. And channel 2, 3, and 4 are the colors as they should be. But this is where it gets interesting, because channel 9 is actually the flash. Then channel 10 is the movement, and 11 is the presets. This is why I suggest getting a board as this, just so you can test your lights and play around with what they actually are. Because coming from Chinese manufacturers, these instruction manuals are most often than not completely wrong. But yeah, that's just to wrap up a little bit of how all of these DMX lights work, and just a quick overview again. I am outputting to the first one, which goes to the second one, and then to the third one. You can control all of these individually. You can have two, or you can even have three all together. Now, we're going to move on to the second part of this presentation, which is the computer and Artemis side of these lights. Hello, and welcome to part two for DMX for Artemis. In this segment, we're going to go about how you code for Artemis. Now, if you think that, you know, coding is something for people who know all about computers, and it's so difficult, and you'll never be able to do it, you'd be completely wrong. Because DMX for Artemis is really simple. It just takes a little bit of explanation. Okay, so let's go to it. First, you're going to want to get to your computer screen here. It'll be under the computer tab if you're in Windows. And you're going to want to go to your C drive here, Windows 7 OS C. Click on that. Then you're going to want to go to Program Files, times 86, or x86. Under this, Artemis should be one of the first files you find, right here, Artemis. And then under Artemis, you're going to want to go to your DAT file, D-A-T. Now, under here, you're going to scroll down to D for DMX, and your DMX commands that Artemis will use is this file right here, named specifically dmxcommands.xml. Now, I have multiple DMX commands files here, just for the simple fact of when I was playing around originally, I just kept them for posterity. So I just opened up them the wrong way. This, if you double click on it right away, the XML file will open up in Internet Explorer. Now, you don't want this. It makes it a lot tougher to edit, and this just makes it just a lot tougher. You have a hard time changing commands, and you just don't want to deal with this. So what you want to do is you want to right-click on the file, then open with Notepad. It's that simple. Okay, so here we go. Okay, so right here you see the Notepad file that I opened with the DMX commands. Now, these... Oh, shit. Okay, jump cut complete. So here we are. This is the dmxcommands.xml file opened in Notepad. You're going to find a few things here, mainly the commands. It'll start off with the coding stuff for DMX, you know, at the top here. If you want to make a note, all you do is you have the less than sign, then a exclamation point. And you can do anything you want between that and the end, which you end with a space, then you make an arrow, a dash, dash, and another, or a greater than sign. And then that will be a note. So you want to do it exactly like this. You don't want to change it. And we're going to scroll down a little bit here to do the normal condition, which starts up and is always on except when you go to shields or something of that type. Okay, so each event, it begins with a title, and it has event type equals. Then in quotation marks, you have whatever condition you pick from this list down here. Artemis has an entire list of commands you can do with DMX, such as player shields raised, player shields on, player shields lower, and so on and so forth. And you would have that in the quotation marks. Now we're going to go back up here. Back to normal condition one. And you will always want to put continuous equals yes. I'm not quite sure what this does, but changing it is never a good thing. You can go on the forums and check and see what it means, but I don't know. Okay, then under each title here, we have a description of what the DMX lights will do. And this is a steady, soft, white light. Now, as I described in part one, there are certain channels that the DMX works on. Now, you're going to want to start all of these. It all starts with a set value, then it says index, value, change. Plus, I have a note for each of my lights. Now, this is not what your DMX file is going to look like originally. Originally, it's going to have a set value, index, and then 1 through 3 for just generic lights. But that's why I went on in the beginning to say you want to test your lights with a board so you can see what each channel does and, you know, make sure that you have everything completely right. Because, you know, just having a little wrong in here will screw up everything. So first, we're going to deal with the first channel of the first light. Now, that was the can that I showed you, and it will be index 0. Because what Artemis does is, it will read from this file, and it'll take 0, which is the index number, and it will add 1 to it. Because in reality, because the lights are based off of a binary system, it goes from 0 to 254. Because in binary, or in pretty much anything but base 10, you count up from 0. It says 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 in binary would be 3, because you start from 0. It's very complex, hard to wrap your head around, but you're going to always want to start from 0, and that will be your first channel. Now, since we want a steady, soft light, we want to set a value, and the value is, it can do different things, such as for the can, 0 in the value would mean it would be off, since it is the overall brightness and the flashing for the can. Then you want to go, and we want to set this to 255 since we want it to be the maximum brightness. Then in channel 1, this controls the red LEDs, and we want to set this to 255, which is the highest, for the brightness. And again, you find out what all of these values are by playing with your lights on a board, or at least that's how I did it. Channel 2 is green, 255, same way. Channel 3, blue. Okay, there's channels 1 through 4. And now that will control both cans, since you have them both set to channel 1. And you don't want to play with change, because basically what change does is if you put a value in there over the time block that this evaluates to, it will change that value that you set based on what you put in for change. So the way I understand it anyway is if I were to put 100 in here, it would change this value by 100 over 1,000 milliseconds. Because this is evaluated over a time block of 1,000 milliseconds. So then we're going to go on to channels 4 through 10. Now this controls the disco ball. Channel 4 is the overall brightness again. Channel 5, 6, and 7 are the red, green, and blue respectively. And then 7 is the, eight is the flashing, 9 is the position, and 10 is the presets. So we're going to set all of these to a steady light of brightness, so we're not going to do anything with the flashing, the position, or the presets. So we set the brightness overall to 255 to have the max, then all the rest to 255 to have the max for that. Then I suggest if you're going to code this, you should comment all of your code. So I'm going to give you this file. You can go ahead and see what all of my things are. Then this evaluates for, it's the same for everything else. You want shields on, which you saw it's going to be blue. So I set the brightness, the overall brightness for the can to the max, and then I just have blue on. See here, 255 on blue. And also, I have 255 for blue on the disco ball. And you can do these combinations for pretty much anything. You know, we have here rear shield low. We have tractored for dock. Completely docked, and all of these are different colors and different settings. It's a little confusing at first, but if you follow this file format, it's very finicky, so you're going to want to, you know, make sure everything is correct, exactly like this, and you have a lot of options. It's really the sky is the limit. If you can imagine it, you can do it, because in these blocks here, let's go back up to normal condition. It doesn't have to be just 0 through 10. It can be 0 through, you know, 255. So you can have 255 channels on here. And, you know, you can have each light controlled individually. So you can have the sky be the limit, really. So yeah, that is really the second portion for this. Again, you're going to want to save this as dmxcommands.xml, capital D, capital M, capital X, then commands in lowercase .xml. And Artemis will just take this and run whatever is in here. You don't need to do anything real fancy. You don't need to download any other software. Just use Notepad. And yeah. I'm sorry if I really keep going back over things. It helps me to remember, but also I feel it will help you to remember. If you want to get more complex with this stuff, I suggest going on the forums, or you can contact me. And you are more than welcome to use my files here, since you are more than likely to buy very similar equipment to mine. So yeah. Thank you for watching part two, and we will be continuing with the demonstration of... Hello and welcome to the final part of this video, where I show you how Artemis actually works with these lights. It's kind of amazing, and the first time it actually worked, I was stunned. So now I'm just going to do a little bit of setup, and I can show you how it actually works. Okay, just going off of my software here. Now, first you have to have this Artemis window already open. And first you're going to want to click Start Server. And you already have everything hooked up. And I'm just going to go to Solo Game. Now, as soon as I press start game, you're going to see that my lights immediately come on. And that's because I already have it hooked up so that I have a ready position where the lights are on all the time, and they change from that. See, now, you saw that come on, and this is the ready position for the server. I'm now going to start up another instance of Artemis. Just going to move the window over here. And I'm going to connect to my own server. Connect. And of course, the server IP changed, because why not? Okay, now I'm going to connect to the server. And I'm going to put it as helm and comms, because these are the main, or sorry, I'm going to put it as weapons and comms, because these are the main places where we're going to be able to change things directly. So I start up this version of Artemis, and first of all, you can see we're in the ready position with these lights. Now I'm going to turn the shields on, and they're going to turn blue. So look at that. Isn't that amazing? I just love that. Okay, now we're going to go to comms, and we're going to go to red alert. Probably one of the coolest things. See, look at that. I have it so the red is moving, but also the cans are solid red. And this will keep going as long as you have red alert on. So once you turn it off, it turns off. I also have it programmed for several other features, such as docking, and when it is docked, it'll turn green, but also it'll flash kind of in a random way when you get hit. Now, this is the final culminating of all of your efforts, and I congratulate you on watching this video all the way through, and I thank you so much for taking this journey with me, and if you have any questions, any comments, any concerns, I'm not an expert, but I'm willing to help you out. We can Skype, we can Facebook message, we can, you know, do it over the forums, whatever you are most comfortable with. I am on all forms of social media, and I am willing to help you 100%. Okay? Thank you very much. I hope you like and subscribe, because I'm going to have a whole bunch more videos with DMX Lighting coming out soon, and also on a whole variety of topics. Okay? Have a good day.